back in the mid-90s, Sheikh Zayed came back to look for water in Al-Ain. And one of the places that he went there is Mubazzara Al-Khadra, the green Mubazzara, which is now is the, one of the most attractive tourist place for tourists to come from Dubai, Sharjah, and even Al-Ain residents. So he asked these, the engineers or some people there in his staff to search for water. And he brought some experts. And then asked him to, he said, I know or I knew that this place has some water. And he pointed to some places there and asked them to take photo, aerial photos, to see whether there is an underground water or not. The experts, the German experts, actually did their job, and they came back to Sheikh Zayed and told him they found underground water. On the 4th of July, 1995, Sheikh Zayed came to witness digging the sulfurite water. And then it was a happy day for Al-Ain inhabitants, since the water is a precious commodity in a desert environment or climate. So, thanks to Sheikh Zayed efforts. Before Sheikh Zayed, before July 1995, it was a deserted area. When he came, Sheikh Zayed, as all people say, he's barakah, he's a bounty wherever he travels. So when he resided there or settled there for a time and he inspected the work there, he created some kind of activities or family recreation. So he ordered building some playgrounds and some villa, and he told them to rent them for free for people. Yeah, some compounds. He also designed Mubazzara by himself. He didn't hire a consultant. So if you go how the big lake was drawn, Sheikh Zayed. How this greenery was spread, designed by Sheikh Zayed. How the road, Sheikh Zayed. So one of the consultants told me it was his design, Sheikh Zayed design. So his design, his idea, and then he brought water, after he brought water, so he designed all these beautiful facilities, which people now enjoy. People doubted that Sheikh Zayed could be able to grow in this very sultry soil. But he challenged them and he succeeded.